गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. सो इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव टॉक अबाउट इस मैटर अराउंड अस प्योर और नॉट. सो नाउ लेट्स मूव फॉरवर्ड एंड टॉक अबाउट अनदर चैप्टर दैट इज नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज. जैसा कि आप लोग जानते हैं कि हमारे जो प्रीवियस वीडियोज थी उसमें हमने इस मैटर अराउंड अस प्योर और नॉट उस चैप्टर के बारे में स्टडी किया था. तो आज हम अपना जो है नेक्स्ट चैप्टर स्टार्ट करेंगे, दैट इज हमारा जो है नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज है. तो चैप्टर का नेम आपका क्या है? नेचुरल रिसोर्स. ओके, सो लेट स्टार्ट अवर वीडियो. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट वी टॉक अबाउट द हेडिंग ऑफ दिस चैप्टर इज नेचुरल रिसोर्स. सो नेचुरल सिंपली डिनोट्स दैट नेचर एंड रिसोर्सेज मीन्स द सोर्सेज विच आर यूज बाय अस फॉर अवर एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ लाइफ. सो now you better understand about what the chapter is on. So in this chapter we will talk about physical resources, that is about air, water, soil, then pollution, about air, water and soil, biogeochemical cycles, that is about water, oxygen, carbon, nitrogen, and one of the important layer of earth, that is ozone layer. So let's talk about the resources. Actually, resources are basically provided by nature on earth and which can be utilized by living organisms to sustain their life. That are basically known as your natural resources. So these resources include your air, water, soil, sunlight, minerals, etc. Understood? That means the resources which are present are provided by earth to you for your survival and existence of your life, that are basically known as your natural resources. And these resources are basically air, water, soil, sunlight, minerals, so on. So agar hum resources ki baat kare to resources basically hote kya hai aapke, jo hame earth kya karti hai, provide karwati hai. क्यों? ताकि हम अपनी लाइफ को क्या करें, जी सकें, सस्टेन कर सकें, एडजस्ट कर सकें. इसलिए हमें जो है आपकी वो आपका क्या कहलाता है, नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज कहलाता है. एंड दे दीज ऑल रिसोर्सेज आर फाउंड एक्युमुलेटेड इन डिफरेंट लेयर ऑफ अर्थ. दैट मीन्स दे आर प्रेजेंट इन डिफरेंट लेयर ऑफ अर्थ. यानी कि ये अर्थ की डिफरेंट लेयर्स में आपकी क्या होंगी, प्रेजेंट होंगी. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द डिफरेंट लेयर्स ऑफ अर्थ. First is, you know that lithosphere. And what is lithosphere? Actually, the outer crust of our planet, which we called as land, is present in lithosphere. Another one is your hydrosphere. And it is basically, you know that our earth is covered with 75% of water. And this water is found to be present in sea, oceans, river, lakes, streams, pond, underground waters, so on. So that is why our earth is also known as your blue planet, because of presence of lot of plenty of water. And another layer which is present is, that is known as your atmosphere. And what is atmosphere? It is a multi-layered gases envelope of air that covers our whole earth. It's just like a blanket which covers us. And another one is your biosphere. It is the life supporting zone of the earth. And here the atmosphere, the hydrosphere and the lithosphere interact with each other and make life possible. So you know here that living things like plant and animals forms the biotic component, and non-living thing, that is air, water and land, forms the abiotic components, and these two forms our biosphere. So agar hum baat kare aapki earth ki layers ki, to sabse pehle जो है आपकी land जिसे हम बोलते हैं, वो वाली layer आपकी क्या कहलाती है, lithosphere कहलाती है. हाइड्रोस्फीयर यानी कि जिसमें आपका क्या है, पानी पाया जाता है. पानी आपका पाया कहाँ जाता है, सी में, ओशंस में, रिवर में, लेक्स में, स्ट्रीम्स में, पॉन्ड में, ये सारा आपका क्या कहलाता है, हाइड्रोस्फीयर कहलाता है. क्योंकि हमारे पास बहुत ज़्यादा पानी है, तो इसलिए हमारे जो अर्थ है उसे क्या बोला जाता है, आपका ब्लू प्लैनेट भी बोला जाता है. तीसरा, हमारे अर्थ में एक कवर होती है, जो हमें क्या करता है, प्रोटेक्ट करता है, तो वो लेयर आपकी कौन सी होती है, दैट इज एटमॉस्फेयर। लास्ट वन वाली आपकी क्या है, बायोस्फेयर, जहाँ पे आपका पूरा जो लाइफ है हम अपनी क्या करते हैं, सस्टेन करते हैं। कैसे, नॉन लिविंग थिंग और लिविंग थिंग आपस में क्या करते हैं, इंटरेक्ट होते हैं, बातचीत होती है, एडजस्टमेंट होता है, और उसके बाद हम अपनी लाइफ को क्या करते हैं, आपका सस्टेन करते हैं। तो नाउ वी विल टॉक अबाउट रिसोर्सेज ऑन द अर्थ एंड देयर इम्पोर्टेंस। एज आई हैव टोल्ड यू अर्लियर दैट द नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज विच आर प्रेजेंट ऑन अर्थ आर एयर, वाटर एंड लैंड। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल नो अबाउट द एयर, एंड एयर इज बेसिकली नोन एज द ब्रेथ ऑफ लाइफ। सो यू नो दैट एयर इज अ मिक्सचर ऑफ मैनी गैसेस लाइक नाइट्रोजन, ऑक्सीजन, कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एंड वाटर वेपर्स। सो दिस प्रीसियस कंपोनेंट ऑफ दीज गैसेस मेक्स लाइफ पॉसिबल ऑन द अर्थ एंड ऑल काइंड ऑफ सेल्स, वेदर यूकैरियोटिक और प्रोकैरियोटिक्स, दे नीड्स ऑक्सीजन। वाई दे नीड ऑक्सीजन्स, एक्चुअली फॉर द ब्रेकडाउन ऑफ ग्लूकोज मॉलिक्यूल एंड टू गेट एनर्जी दे नीड ऑक्सीजन। सो यू हैव रीड इन प्रीवियस क्लासेस अ प्रीवियस कॉन्सेप्ट अबाउट रेस्पिरेशन एंड देयर एक्सचेंज ऑफ गैसेज। सो हेयर यू नो दैट दैट ऑक्सीजन इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर एवरीथिंग, फॉर द प्रोसेस ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन एंड फॉर दैट ब्रेकडाउन ऑफ ग्लूकोज मॉलिक्यूल वी नीड समथिंग दैट इज योर एयर और एयर कंपोनेंट। सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द एयर, इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ एयर एंड कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ एयर विच मेक्स अस फॉर सस्टेन अवर लाइफ। गैसेस विच आर प्रेजेंट इन एयर दे मेक्स एन एनवलप एंड दैट एनवलप इज नोन एज योर एटमोसफियर। इट हैज मैनी सिग्निफिकेंट रोल टू प्ले सच एज प्रोटेक्शन फ्रॉम अल्ट्रावायलेट रेडिएशंस और फॉर मेकिंग एन कम्युनिकेशन बिटवीन अस एंड योर एयर। सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द इम्पोर्टेंस और अबाउट एटमोसफेयर इन डिटेल। सो जैसा कि आप जो मैंने बताया था आपका कि आपको जो है रिसोर्सेस में आपका एयर, वाटर और लैंड के बारे में हम इस चैप्टर में स्टडी करेंगे, तो पहले हम एयर के बारे में जान लेते हैं। एयर आपका होते क्या है, जनरली आपका क्या है, मिक्सचर है गैसेस का, जैसे नाइट्रोजन, ऑक्सीजन, कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड और साथ साथ वाटर वेपर का। और इन गैसेस के कंपोजिशन की वजह से ही जो है हमारी जो लाइफ है वो आपकी क्या है, पॉसिबल है अर्थ पे। दूसरा, चाहे वो कोई भी सेल हो, आपकी यूकैरियोटिक सेल हो, चाहे आपकी प्रोकैरियोटिक सेल हो, हर किसी को क्या चाहिए, ग्लूकोज चाहिए, सॉरी ऑक्सीजन चाहिए। क्यों चाहिए ऑक्सीजन? फॉर ब्रेकिंग डाउन ऑफ ग्लूकोज मॉलिक्यूल। अब ग्लूकोज मॉलिक्यूल को तोड़ना क्यों है? क्योंकि अगर हम ग्लूकोज मॉलिक्यूल को नहीं तोड़ेंगे तो हमें क्या है, एनर्जी नहीं मिलेगी, और एनर्जी नहीं मिलेंगी तो हम क्या है, काम नहीं कर पाएंगे, कोई भी एक्टिविटी हम क्या है, परफॉर्म नहीं कर पाएंगे। तो फॉर डैट हमें क्या चाहिए, ऑक्सीजन चाहिए। और वो ऑक्सीजन हमें कौन प्रोवाइड करती है, आपकी एयर प्रोवाइड करती है। तो इन जो गैसेस आपकी एयर में प्रेजेंट होती है, ये क्या करते हैं, एक एनवलप का फॉर्मेशन करते हैं, और उस एनवलप का नाम क्या होता है, आपका एटमोसफेयर। सो आइए उस एटमॉस्फेयर के बारे में थोड़ा और डिटेल में हम जो है जान लेते हैं कि आखिर आपका जो एटमॉस्फेयर है वो आपका होता क्या है। तो जैसा कि आपने देखा कि एटमॉस्फेयर, अभी मैंने बताया कि आपका क्या है, वो मिक्सचर ऑफ गैसेस है, और वो क्या करता है, एक एनवलप क्रिएट कर देता है, और उस एनवलप को हम क्या बोलते हैं, आपका एटमॉस्फेयर बोलते हैं। एक्चुअली द एटमॉस्फेयर कवर्स द अर्थ लाइक अ प्रोटेक्टिव ब्लैंकेट। So you know that air is a bad conductor of heat, so the atmosphere prevents the sudden increase in temperature during the day hours, and similarly during night it slows down the escape of heat into the outer surface, and thus it keeps the average temperature of earth fairly during the day and during the night of whole year. That means it ensures the right amount of heat is received by earth, and it also controls and allows to living organisms to survive. So this is an important role which is played by atmosphere. And here is some knowledgeable point that another planet like Venus and Mars, there is no life. Why there is no life? Because of presence of carbon dioxide in abundant amount. So this question may arise sometime that why there is life only on Earth? It can be on Venus or Mars, na? But no. So the main reason is that the major in that planet, the major component is your carbon dioxide, and which is harmful for life, for the existence of life. So जैसा कि आप जानते हैं, आपका जो atmosphere है वो एक blanket है gases का. दूसरा ये क्या करता है आपका, आपको जो हमारी हवा है वो आपकी क्या है, बेड कंडक्टर होती है हीट की. तो ये हमें क्या है, एटमॉस्फेयर हमें बचाता है किस चीज़ से, टेम्परेचर के इंक्रीज और डिक्रीज होने से. दूसरा ये हमारी जो लाइफ लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म है उसको सर्वाइव करने में भी हेल्प करता है. अगर टेम्परेचर ज़रूरत से ज़्यादा होगा तो कहीं ना कहीं हमें क्या है, दिक्कत होगी एडजस्ट करने के लिए. तो उससे प्रोटेक्शन का काम किसका होता है, आपका एटमॉस्फेयर का काम होता है. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट अनदर कंपोनेंट, दैट इज अबाउट विंड. सो व्हेन द एयर मूव्स, दैट मूविंग एयर इज नोन एज योर विंड. And wind results due to changes taking place in atmosphere like heating of air or formation of water vapors. So let's talk about the following event due to which wind occurs. So first one is that when solar radiations falls on Earth, so majority of these radiations are reflected back. That means they re-radiated by land or water bodies. So some of that radiations are absorbed, but due to reflected of reflection, the convection current are set up in air, and due to that current, land get heated faster than water, and the air over land would also be heated faster than the air over water bodies. Another event is in coastal regions during the day, the air above the land get heated faster and start rising. As these air rises, so you know that a low pressure is created between among them, and air over the sea moves to the region of low pressure, and the movement of air from one region to another creates the wind. So direction of that time the wind would be from sea to the land during the day. So while at the night, both land and sea started getting cool. So by their cooling, water cools down slowly than land, and the air above the water would be warmer than the air above the land. So here what will happen, land air moves to low pressure area. We have talked about that land air move will be moving will be low pressure area. So direction of wind would be from land to sea during night. Other factors that influence the wind are rotation of earth and presence of mountain ranges in path of wind. Various phenomena occurring in the atmosphere such as cyclone, thunderstorm are also due to movement of air, and they are caused by uneven heating of atmosphere in different regions. Let's talk about the another component, that is rain. So actually rainfall also occurs by the some event which occurs in the atmosphere. So let's talk about some events like water bodies are heated by solar radiations during the day. So due to this, a large amount of water evaporates, and these goes into the air as water vapors, and various biological activities also add some amount of water in the atmosphere. So due to that, air also becomes hot during the sunlight, and it start rising up along with water vapor. So as the air rises, it expands and cool. This cooling causes the water vapors in the air to condense in the form of tiny droplets. So condensation of water is facilitated by dust and other particles, and they also act as nucleus for drop to other around. And due to that, tiny droplets of water appears in the form of clouds. Once the water droplets are formed, they grow bigger by further condensation. And when the drops have grown bigger and bigger, they falls down in the form of rain. Sometimes when the temperature of air is low enough, precipitations may occur in the form of snow, slate or hail. So let's talk about what happens when there is an increase in the composition of harmful or undesirable substance in the air. So it causes pollution. It makes air polluted. So it can also be defined as like an undesirable alternation physical, chemical or biological characters of air is known as air pollution. So what are the causes of air pollution? So some of the causes I am discussing here, very basic causes of air pollution. So let's talk about the cause of air pollution. So first one is excessive burning of fossil fuels. Like coal and petroleum produces high amount of oxide of nitrogen and sulfur, and these oxide get mixed with atmosphere or moisture which are present in the environment, and that causes acid rains. So it leads to many harmful effect like corrosion of monuments. For example, you know that Taj Mahal, when it was built, so it was very beautiful and very white, but due to acid rain it is getting pale day by day. So this is the reason of acid rain, or this is caused by the acid rain. So another one is that many industries release high amount of poisonous gases which makes our air pollute, and dust also causes our pollution, and it also affects us by causing respiratory disease like asthma, lung cancer, pneumonia, irritation in eyes, defect in lungs, and acid rain, and it also produce smog. So you know what is smog? Actually, the presence of high level of pollutant in air reduces the visibility. Actually, it happens in cold weather where water also get condensed out of air. So that is known as your smog. It is also one of the cause of air pollution. Air pollution can also cause a greenhouse effect, which leads to your global warming. As you know that temperature is changing day by day. So this is also a reason of your air pollution. So for preventing air pollution, we should create awareness and we should use less of vehicles. Because due to in vehicles we use fossil fuels like petrol and that, and due to that fossil fuels, it get combusted when it is get combusted out or heated out, it increases the amount of suspended particles, and these suspended particles are generally unburned, and that causes the air pollution. So if we should also follow one of the major step, that is sustainable development, and you know that sustainable development is that development in which we use resources for our generation also, and we save that resources for future generation also. So this is all about one natural resource, that is air. So let's talk about the another natural resource, that is water. Let's talk about the water. Water is known as a wonder liquid. So it is an inexhaustible natural resource. That means it can't be exhausted, and it occupies very large area of the earth surface, that is both above and under the ground. So some amount of water exists in the form of water vapor in the atmosphere, and most of the water on earth surface are found in seas and ocean, and that water is basically your saline. That means salt is present in that. And if we talk about fresh water, it is found at frozen ice caps, at poles, snow covered mountains or rivers, lake and pond. So let's talk about the importance of water for living being. So it is essential for every cellular process, for transport of substance, for the reaction which is taking place in our body. For everything, in every level, we need water. The availability of water decides the number of individual of species that are able to survive in particular area, and also the diversity of life there. So you know that from this statement you basically understand about the importance of water. So this water is also polluted by harmful substance, and that is known as your water pollution. So if you talk about the definition of that, that is an undesirable change in the physical, chemical and biological quality of water. So what make that water polluted? Actually, water dissolved fertilizers and pesticides from agricultural field with surface rain of rainwater. It takes them to the nearby water bodies where they cause harmful effects on aquatic life. Another one is dumping of sewage and waste. And another one is industry use water for cooling in various operations. And they also dump their waste in aquatic life form and aquatic region. So that causes the air water polluted. Some of our activities also, we use our to throw our domestic waste into the river. We wash our clothes in that. So this activity actually makes our water polluted. So what happens about the effect of water pollution? What are the effects when water get polluted? So one is that it causes, first of all, it damages the aquatic life form, because in fertilizers, pesticide, dirt, sewage, industrial wastes, heavy metals, mercury and lead at present. This causes disease causing microorganisms, and that make unfit for that make water unfit for consumptions. And due to microorganisms get, you know, that they get multiply very fastly. So due to this, they affect flora and fauna which are present in the water bodies. And due to water pollution, temperature, or you can observe change in temperature also. And what it affects for human, what it affects in human is that generally causes infections like bacterial infection, fungi infection, fungal infections, typhoid, cholera, jaundice. So it is our major duty to protect water from getting it polluted, because after completing this topic, you understand basically about the importance of water. So it is our major duty to protect it from polluted. So several programs are organized by government too. So please take participated in that about your protecting the natural, that is our natural resources, which is your water. So by closing the tap, using water in sustainable, that can help to get less polluted regions. Thank you.